Your database can hold a lot of information, and not all of it is relevant when you're doing a specific task or workflow within your process. That, my friends, is where interfaces are going to come into play. So in this video, I am breaking down how to get started with Airtable interfaces so that you can build a more streamlined workflow for your operations. If that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, where I make it my mission to help you save up to 20 hours of your time every week with no-code tools and automation. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we deliver those kinds of results for our clients, you'll want to start with my free webinar training. You can sign up at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration, and you will get instant access to my one-hour presentation that walks through how to think about and frame automation so that you can start leveraging that tool. But without further ado, let's hop into this video. I'm going to be talking about Airtable interfaces specifically for newbies, people who have just started adopting the Airtable software and they really want to unlock the power of an interface so that they can get better results from their workflows. Let's go ahead and hop on into my screen. We are going to be starting with this database that I just used for the most recent video that we did, where we were showing project tracking. The important takeaway here, if you didn't get a chance to watch that video, is that we have projects that link to tasks. So we have a bunch of different tasks that are going to connect to a project, and we want to be able to see the different tasks that we have that are relating to a specific project. It's kind of a lot to have to flip between these two different things. To flip between projects and tasks takes a couple of clicks, and I would rather have a more interactive view where I can see my projects and my tasks assigned to that specific project as I drill down into it. That's exactly where interfaces are going to come into play. So let's go ahead and set up an interface. In the upper left-hand corner, you can click on interfaces and you get taken to this screen here that's going to kind of walk you through if you're brand new to interfaces. You can check this out if you're interested. I will skip it for now and just go to start building. Once inside, you can name this particular interface. Let's call this task dashboard and drop a description if you'd like. Now, Airtable has made this as easy as possible, so you can also plug into some existing templates. So one for record review, one for dashboard, one for record summary, but I want to start off with a blank template here because I want to actually build these pieces one by one. So I'll select blank canvas and click finish. This is going to set me up in my first interface, and in the bottom left corner of my screen is where I see the different interface elements. Now you can see that you can add some text, dividers, grid, timeline chart, number, record picker, filter, etc. For the purpose of building our specific interface, we have projects that relate to tasks. So of course, I want to see the different projects that I have going on, but also want to be able to select one of those projects, drill into it, and get greater insight as to the tasks assigned to that project, both incomplete tasks and also complete tasks. So let's start with a record picker. I can select a record picker, and wherever I want to drop this is where it's going to show up. I'll do it here on the side. And what this is doing is asking me, well, what table do you want to pick those records from? Now, of course, I want to be able to select something from my projects table that then drills into the tasks for that specific project. So the way that this has defaulted, it's already set up to look at my projects table, and that's exactly what I want. If you'd like to build a filter in here, what this means is you will filter out anything that does not pass that filter. So for example, let's say that you had a complete checkbox in your projects table and you wanted to only look at active projects. Well, then you could apply a filter where you only bring in the projects that are still not completed. This way you wouldn't accidentally look back at a past project and instead you would only see those ongoing projects in your database. Now for us, we only have some example data here and I haven't built that complete checkbox, so I'll skip the filter. You can also choose to sort these different elements in the record picker. So if you wanted to sort everything alphabetically by the name of the project, for example, you would do it just like this. Now, inside of here, if you want to show a label, great. Otherwise, you can toggle it off. You see that the label here in the upper left corner is going to label it with whatever that source is. in this case, the projects. You can change that, of course, and rename it. So I might say project picker. And there it is, that label is being brought in. And I can also choose to resize this if I'd like. That way it fits on my interface a little bit more cleanly. Now let's talk about some other elements that we can add here as well. Maybe we take comments inside of that project record and we want to bring the comments into this interface so that we can see them at a glance. I can add those record comments in, drop them in anywhere, and resize as needed. Maybe I'll shrink that down just a little bit more and keep it right there. Again, with the comments, we can choose to change the way this shows up. So I could call this project comments. And we can move on from here. Now, something to note is that these comments are actually connected to the project picker. See that we are inside of the project picker right here when we have selected the comments. So what this means is that we will only see the comments for the project that is selected right here. So if a different project is selected from the picker, well then the comments, of course, are going to correspond with whatever project that is. It's important to note that these comments are tied to that project picker, because otherwise the project picker that we put into our interface isn't going to do much of anything. Now, the other thing we want to see is our tasks. Let's take a look at how we can bring tasks in. Again, inside of the project picker, inside of that element that we've set up, we can scroll down here and look at the type link. That doesn't impact us here, but the tasks actually does. And inside of tasks, then we can choose how we want to look at this. If we had dates for our tasks, we might want to look at it in a timeline. If it was some sort of a chart or mathematical data, we might want to look at it on a chart. We could also look at a summary of that data by bringing in a number if we wanted to take an average or if we wanted to count or things like that. And of course, in our case, we actually just want to look at those different tasks. So we can drill in here and grab it either by the field or a grid view. I can drop this grid right into my interface, and here are not only the tasks, but more importantly, the tasks that pertain to the specific project. You'll notice that the project's link here, where we've connected to the project, it's only showing those tasks that are related to this particular project. And if I chose another project from the list, everything changes. Inside of my tasks here, they swap out. Now, let's talk about how we might dive a little deeper into this. Maybe I want to break this up. I want to look at my completed tasks in one little section, and I want to look at my incomplete tasks in another section of my interface. I can absolutely do that. Inside of the setup for this particular tasks element, I have a lot of options to pick from. I can apply a filter where perhaps I add a condition that says, I only want to bring in those tasks that are marked incomplete. So again, remember, of course, I'm only going to see tasks that pertain to the record selection that I've chosen from my projects level, but now I've added an additional filter that says not only do they have to belong to that project, but they also must not be completed. I can then shrink this down, and if I want to apply a sort here, I can do that as well. Maybe I want to put these in alphabetical order, but it probably makes more sense in this case to actually bring in the order of the task. You may recall from the previous tutorial that using the order field here, we're able to rank the different tasks so that they have some sort of a hierarchy. And in this case, I'm going to use that order to sort them so that the next task due for the project is actually going to show up at the top, and there will be some sort of chronological order to these tasks. Let's add another grid view now, and I'll plop this right under the first one, and this time I want to apply the opposite filter. So I might say these are the tasks in which complete is complete. So this way I'm actually able to see which tasks are completed, which tasks are incomplete as it pertains to that particular project. Now let's sort this around a little bit better and resize the way this is showing up. Again, this is an interface, and so the idea is you're trying to make it something that allows you to easily view all the information that you need to see in one simple screen rather than having to flip around to a dozen different places. Before I move on, let me also add a sort here to the order for my completed tasks, and I'll make those rank from 1 to 9 as well. And the next piece I want to do is actually filter in what information is showing up here. Let's pop open the fields here, and take a look at what's showing up. Do I need to see the order field? Once they're sorted in a particular order, it's kind of irrelevant what the order is, so long as they're sorted. So I can hide that. I know, obviously, that they're connected to the project that I've selected, so this is redundant information. I can hide that as well. I definitely want to see who the person in charge is, and I'll keep that complete checkbox there as well. And the nice thing about this is I can actually activate that checkbox if I have edit access to the database. Then I will also have edit access to the interface, and I don't have to go into the database to mark a task as complete. I can do it right here in my interface, and it all stays connected. Similarly, I'm going to hide the same fields here in my completed section. So I'll pop open my fields, I'll hide the order again, and I will hide the project's link. And we might choose, in addition to this, to actually group by the person in charge. This might make it easier for us to see who has a lot of outstanding tasks for a particular project. We'll group by the person in charge there, and I'll apply the same filter over here to my other section, and just drop this in as well. So, here we go. We have a nice interface built where I can take comments on a particular project, see the incomplete tasks for that project, and see the completed tasks for that project as well. Then in one easy click, I can select a different project from my list of active projects, and everything else will be updated as well. Here we see that for this particular project, new project for Gap Consulting, none of those tasks are yet completed, and we can see who owns these different tasks. In fact, now that we have more tasks, we better make these little grid views slightly longer so that we can fit more data on the screen. And I can mark these tasks as complete as I knock them out. So by doing so, they will be removed from my incomplete tasks, moved over to my complete tasks. We should probably add a label here as well, just so that we don't get confused. This, of course, is my incomplete tasks. So let's go ahead and change the name there. I'll come up here and make this incomplete. And I will do the same thing over here for my completed tasks, add a label and change it to complete. And we're good to go. Now, any changes that are made in this interface are going to instantly be reflected in the data in the background, and any new data that's added directly to the database is going to instantly show up here as well. Let's just prove that to ourselves. Let's publish the interface first. I'm going to click publish. If you want to share it with someone in particular, you'll get the opportunity to do that on the next screen. You can just type in their email here. And the thing to note is that by doing this, they will also get access to the database itself. So if you only want to share your interface, but not your database, this is a very important thing to know, because in sharing an Airtable built interface, you will be sharing access to the underlying data as well. But let's go ahead and skip this particular stage. I don't have anyone I want to share it with, so I can X out of here. And let's pop back into our database. I can click up here and go to base is an option. I'll right click and open this in a separate window so that I can flip between the two. Let's actually add a new project here. I'll add a new project. I'll make this a type 1 project, and I will call this project 3. And I'm going to run the script that we built in last time. In fact, if you recall, we have a nice little script that's going to create all of our tasks for this new project based on the type of project that it is. So I'm going to make a selection here. I'm going to run this for project 3. And we're going to see that it automatically creates all those tasks for project 3. I can assign a couple of these to myself, and maybe we would assign some to other team members as well. Let's pop back to our interface now and take a look. I can select project 3 from the dropdown, and sure enough, all of those tasks are showing up right here. As they're marked complete, just as before, they're going to get moved from the incomplete tasks into my complete tasks. Everything's working beautifully, and I don't have to look at a database now. I can live in my interface to get my work done. And that is the point of interfaces, making it easier for us to get what we need to get done and keeping everything that we need to see in one clean interface. I hope you got a ton of value out of this video. If you did, be sure to subscribe to the channel for more upcoming tutorials, and I will see you in the next one.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, And we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.